Hi everybody, I'm Ellen with the Caldwell Arts Council, and today we're here to show you our current exhibit entitled Hunter-Gatherers on Smartphones. This exhibition is very different from what we normally have. It is what we call social commentary art. This show takes a critical look at our contemporary culture and how that affects us on a lot of levels. A lot of the pieces here revolve around our food system and what we eat. There are pieces in here that are really lovely, but this is a show that will make people think. So it's not so much art for art's sake. It is definitely social commentary. So if you want to see something a little different, please. This exhibition runs through March 27th, so please come see us. The artists in this show are Amber Watts and Joe Bigley. Amber is from Morganton. She teaches art at Caldwell Community College. Joe Bigley lives in Patterson. He is a co-founder of the Western North Carolina Sculpture Center, and he teaches art at Appalachian State. The two of them got together and more or less planned this exhibition. This exhibition features two-dimensional and three-dimensional art created by Amber Watts and Joe Bigley. Amber lives in Morganton and teaches at Caldwell Community College. Joe is from Patterson and he teaches art at Appalachian State. Joe's also the co-founder of the Western North Carolina Sculpture Center at Patterson School. This show is a very interesting show. You really ought to come in and see it. It is, as I said, a mix of two-dimensional and three-dimensional art. So there will be there are sculptural components to it, as well as what we call wall art. Everything has kind of a collage feel to it. This show features work by Amber Watts and Joe Bigley. Amber lives in Morganton. She teaches art at Caldwell Community College. And Joe is from Patterson and teaches art at Appalachian State. He's also the co-founder of the Western North Carolina Sculpture Center, which is located on Patterson School's campus. This show features a lot of assemblages, both in two-dimensional and three-dimensional form. It's very sculptural in nature, and there are even pieces that are interactive as well. Please come by and see this fabulous exhibit. Also this month, we are featuring folk artist Vicki Jo Franks in the Sadie's Back Porch Gallery. Vicki Jo is from Shelby. She participates in our sculpture celebration. She is a three-dimensional artist, of course, and everything that she makes is made from, as she puts it, trash. Very cool, very folk art, and she also makes a statement. She is a proponent for she is her own anti-littering campaign, and she's a proponent for spaying and neutering your pets. Virtually everything that she makes has a message physically written on it, which is do not litter and spay and neuter your pets. She also is a big cat lover, so if you love cats, come in and check out her funky little cat sculptures. She also has angels, some horses, and some other folk art type pieces as well.